Hello everyone, welcome to Advanced Knowledge Systems and a warm welcome to AKS IAS Academy. And it offers examination coaching for UPSC, CSC, State Public Service Commission, SSC Combined Graduate Level and CLAT examination. And about me, I'm Sandeep Bhushan Thumala and I take up the analysis of the Hindu newspaper, wherein we will focus at the DNA of the Hindu, that is today's of 17th of April 2021. And throughout my session, I would be emphasizing on the keywords and the key phrases, which wherein we will identify the factual, analytical and conceptual questions, which are critical for UPSC prelims examination. And while you get into the mode of imbibing the keywords and the key phrases in your answer writing for the mains examination, your answers for mains examination would be precise and concise, and thereby you would score higher marks in the mains examination. So this session at AKS IAS Academy Daily News Analysis will certainly help you to crack both prelims and mains of 2021. And before we get into the DNA of the newspaper, we will be focusing at the quote of the day. And the quote of this day says that you may have to fight a battle more than once to win it. So what is very important is never give up when you are putting in efforts and you haven't got the result. So you may have to fight a battle more than once to win it. And now we'll get into the DNA of the newspaper. And here we would be focusing about the pressure or the kind of challenges the girls and the adolescent girls, which wherein they are facing during the pandemic situation. And there has been a study which has been conducted, and the study, the title of the study is COVID Inner Voice, a girl-led and centered participatory research study. And it was released on April 13, 2021. And the title of this study is crucial because we would be focusing at the challenges of the girls between 13 to 24 years, what they have faced or the pressure during the pandemic situation. The title is COVID in Her Voice. And it was conducted by girls at the age of 13 to 24 at Ahmedabad, Alwar, Bareilly, Delhi, Lucknow, Mumbai and Pune. And that study was conducted within their communities of age group of 13 to 24 in that particular locality. And the study was supported by the UK government, and it was conducted by an global philanthropy, that is Empower. And the entire study is focused at risk youth in emerging markets. And this is what the study is all about. The study is all about the risk the youth are facing in the emerging markets, especially during the pandemic situation. So this study would be very much focused for prelims perspective, and the title is COVID in Our Voice. And it is supported by UK government and conducted by Empower, which is a global philanthropy. And the focus is at risk youth are facing in the emerging markets. And the biggest challenge of the girls which are facing is in regards to the inability to attend the online classes during the pandemic situation. And the challenge to face, challenge to attend the online classes is because of the lack of resources to resource and technology. So this is the foremost challenge the girls are facing to attend the online class is because of the lack of access to resource and technology. And if you look at further, the percentage, almost 28% in the study, they have said that they do not have the telephones or mobile phones and the internet access to attend the online classes. And again, when we come forth to not only just attending the online classes, but in regards to the households from marginalized communities, they are facing the financial stress. And this financial stress is that because of the economic impact of COVID-19. And not only the households, that is the girls in the households from the marginalized communities are facing the financial stress, but also the others, the girls, they believe that they are also facing the pressure to get married. And this, the pressure to get married has increased during the COVID-19 pandemic situation, 42%. And almost 90% of the girls which were part of the study and surveyed, they are also facing or they are experiencing the mental distress and despair. And this is because they are experiencing the mental distress and despair because they do not have access to information about the coping mechanism. So that is very much important, that what is the information being provided to the each and every citizen of India, especially the study conducted to the girls, the challenges that they do not have any information about the coping up with the COVID-19 pandemic situation. So these are the biggest challenges. And if you look at the mental distress and the despair which has been aggravated is because of the reason of the mental distress which has been aggravated is because of the barriers in communicating with the friends and teachers. That means they need to have some kind of relief or relief in regards to the mindset what they are facing. So they need to have communicating with the friends and teacher, but there are barriers in communicating with the friends and teacher. That is why the mental distress is aggravating. And there is 26% of the respondents in the study, they have said that there is increase in gender-based violence. And these are the reasons that the kind of challenges the girls are facing during the COVID-19 pandemic situation. And this has the gender-based violence. It is because of the fears and threats of violence which have been intensified because of the restriction on their freedom during the COVID-19 pandemic situation. And if you look at the impact of the COVID-19 on the girls, that is their livelihood or their lives, is on the girls and also the adolescent girls, is in regards to the getting married. That is another reason, is spending longer hours in regards to the household works and the lagged tools to continue school education, that is the online, that is in regards to not having access to mobile phones and internet access, and the increased gender-biased violence. So these are the major challenges which the girls and the adolescent girls have been facing during the COVID-19 pandemic situation. And the study which has been conducted by the support of the UK government and conducted by Empower, the title is COVID in Our Voice. So these are the important points which you can consider as part of the challenges which the girl and the adolescent girls are facing at the age of 13 to 24 during the COVID-19 pandemic situation. So we can consider these as the challenges: getting married, spending longer hours on the household course, lack tools to continue school education online, and also increase in gender-based violence. So these are the challenges which the girls and the adolescent girls are facing during the COVID-19 pandemic situation. This you can consider as the main point of view, that you consider this as the challenges. And now we'll look at the another news, is in regards to the extradition of Nirav Modi. So now there is almost a path which is being cleared by the UK's Home Department that the businessman, that is Nirav Modi's extradition in the Punjab National Bank fraud case, is been almost now ready, that India can, I mean, he would be extradited to India and Indian authorities or agencies can go ahead with questioning him in regards to the Punjab National Bank fraud. And the UK's Home Department has approved the extradition of the diamond merchant Nirav Modi to India in connection with 13,758 crore Punjab National Bank fraud. And if we focus more in depth of what is that, who has approved or who has cleared the approval of the extradition of the diamond merchant Nirav Modi to India, is the Secretary of State of UK's Home Department, Priti Patel, has cleared Nirav Modi's extradition. And if you look at further, there was an order by the Westminster's magistrate court on February 25, 2021 that they have found, that means the Westminster's magistrate court have found the sufficient grounds warranting Mr. Modi's trial in India, thereby extraditing the diamond merchant Nirav Modi to India. So what is that we need to focus here is the Secretary of State or the Westminster's Magistrate Court and the UK's Home Department, the extradition of diamond merchant Nirav Modi to India. And the Secretary of State of UK's department has taken into consideration of clearing the extradition of the diamond merchant Nirav Modi to India on the basis or the record of evidence furnished by Central Bureau of Investigation of India and the Enforcement Directorate, that both these agencies have alleged that Nirav Modi has conspired to destroy the proof against him and also he has intimidated the witnesses. So based on the evidence which has been furnished by the CBI and the ED, they have made sure that there is an evidence, and because of this they have found that he can be extradited to India. And the accused now, that is the diamond merchant Nirav Modi, who has been accused by the Secretary of State, has now the legal recourse. This is the keyword. In spite of Secretary of State making sure that Nirav Modi can be extradited to India, there is one more chance to Nirav Modi that he can take up the legal recourse of approaching the UK High Court. Please do understand here. Here it was the UK's Home Department, that is the Secretary of State, has cleared Nirav Modi's extradition, UK's Home Department. But now Nirav Modi, in spite of the Secretary of State clearing the extradition of diamond merchant Nirav Modi to India, Nirav Modi can again take up he can approach a legal recourse to the UK High Court. But the legal recourse by Nirav Modi can be taken up within 14 days. And that within 14 days is to seek permission from moving an appeal against the Secretary of State, who has taken a decision to clear that the extradition of Nirav Modi to India. So we have another keyword which we need to focus is legal recourse is the option still which is in front of Nirav Modi, which he can approach the UK court, but within 14 days. And according to the UK government's website, unless there is an appeal by the requested person, that is here in this case Nirav Modi should be extradited within 28 days of the Secretary of State decision. So if there is no appeal, that is the legal recourse which Nirav Modi or the accused has approached the UK court, then within 28 days he should be extradited to India. So these are all the legal terms or the legal keywords which you need to focus in regards to the extradition of Nirav Modi in the Punjab National Bank fraud case in connection with 13,758 crore. And the businessman, that is Nirav Modi, has fled in the country on January 1st, 2018. And he was arrested in London on March 19, 2019, and since then he is in judicial custody in London. And the CBI has registered the first case against the diamond merchant and others on January 31st, 2018, because look at the here the sequence. January 1st, 2018, he has fled to UK. And on January 31st, 2018, CBI has registered the first case against the diamond merchant or Nirav Modi that he has cheated the Punjab National Bank. And subsequently, again in the same year 2018, but in the month of August, the first extradition request by the CBI was sent to UK via or through the diplomatic channels. And again, based on the CBI case and the ED, which were carried in regards to the money laundering they have attached, that means Enforcement Directorate, based on the CBI cases, have attached assets worth 100 of crores of Nirav Modi in India and abroad. So that now, based on the proof or the evidence which was furnished by the CBI and ED, the Secretary of State of UK's department has cleared the extradition of Nirav Modi. So here, what is very important is extradition. This is the keyword which you need to focus for prelims perspective of UPSC, because we have extradition treaty, that is, India has extradition treaty with various countries. And you need to focus about the extradition treaty with the UK, because there is a chance, as the Secretary of State for UK's department has approved the extradition treaty or extradition of diamond merchant Nirav Modi to India. And now we will again focus at another news, which the American troops and NATO forces have agreed that they will be withdrawing the forces from Afghanistan. And in the midst of withdrawing the American forces and the NATO forces from Afghanistan, there is a concern which has been raised by India. Definitely, there is a concern within the Afghanistan government also, that what could be the possibility of the, or the repercussions and the consequences of the withdrawal of the American and NATO forces from Afghanistan by this year. So that, would there be any space or the vacuum which will be created, and probably the Taliban would be having a major role in trying to fill the gap. So in regards to that, India's External Affairs Minister, while he was addressing a virtual session at the Raisina Dialogue Summit, this is a keyword. So at the Raisina Dialogue Summit, and this summit is organized by the Ministry of External Affairs and the Observer Research Foundation. And during this virtual summit of the Raisina Dialogue Summit, External Affairs Minister has called for responsible drawdown. Look at the keyword here. He's talking about the withdrawal of the American and NATO forces should be responsible. That there has to be, or he has called for a responsible drawdown of the American and NATO forces from Afghanistan. And he has also said that the US decision to pull out of the forces from Afghanistan is certainly a big step, but it would have a deep consequences in Afghanistan or in the entire Afghanistan peace process reconciliation. And thereby he has said that, that is, External Affairs Minister Jaishankar has said that it is necessary that Afghanistan constitution and democratic process and the rights accorded to women and minorities are certainly taken into consideration, and they should be ensured at or under any circumstances while the American and NATO forces are withdrawing from the Afghanistan. So what is the keyword, or the three keywords which we need to focus as per External Affairs Minister S. Jaishankar in regards to the withdrawal of the American and NATO forces is Afghanistan constitution, democratic processes, and the rights accorded to women and minorities should be ensured at any circumstances or during any circumstances wherein the American and NATO forces would be withdrawing. And the end game in Afghanistan must be united, democratic, and sovereign. So these are all the keywords which you need to focus, while there would be a possibility that how the entire withdrawal of the American and NATO forces should be taken up in Afghanistan, taking in view that the end game of the pullout of the forces from Afghanistan, which is a deep step, could be a deep consequences, because this end game should be in a united, democratic, and sovereign, and also the Afghanistan constitution, democratic processes and the rights of women and minorities should be ensured at all circumstances. So these are the keywords which you need to focus, that how India is worried about, or the statement made by India's external affairs minister. And now we will look at the India's concerns in regards to the withdrawal or the withdrawal of US and NATO forces. And Jay Shankar has indicated India's concern about the hasty withdrawal of the US and allied forces, that is the NATO forces, from Afghanistan, that there is a possibility that it could bring Taliban into a powerful role in Kabul. And this is the deep consequences which Mr. Jay Shankar is worried about, and India is worried about, that the vacuum which would be prevailed after withdrawal of the US forces and the NATO forces from Afghanistan, that it could bring Taliban into a powerful role in Kabul, and it could pose a very big challenging or a threat to the Afghanistan government or Afghanistan military itself. And he has also focused about the India's development assistance to Afghanistan since 2001. That means India has consistently providing developmental assistance to Afghanistan since 2001. And this assistance, developmental assistance, if any of the country feels that this is aimed at Pakistan, that means if India's developmental assistance in Afghanistan is aimed at Pakistan, then it would be an absolute fantasy, and it would cause bilateral differences and regional instability. Please focus this point. If any of the country, especially we are indirectly mentioning about Pakistan, if India's developmental assistance in Afghanistan since 2001, if Pakistan feels that we are just trying to aim at Pakistan, and that is why we are going ahead with the providing developmental assistance to Afghanistan since 2001, then it is an absolute fantasy. And in turn, this kind of thinking would create bilateral differences and regional instability. So these are the two keywords which you need to focus, that the developmental assistance by India provided to Afghanistan since 2001 is to make sure that there is a coordinated bilateral issues taken up, and it is because of regional stability, but not because of bilateral differences, not because of regional stability, which Pakistan is actually trying to portray it as an absolute fantasy. And he has also said that India's role in the developmental assistance to Afghanistan is in regards to the construction of Afghanistan parliament and this construction of the Salma Dam, and also various networks in Afghanistan is a positive step, that is in regards to creating bilateral differences which should be resolved, and providing regional stability in the heart of Asia. So this is the way we need to focus in regards to the international relations and in regards to the withdrawal of the Afghanistan and NATO forces. And the third one is India's role in Afghanistan reconciliation peace process. Afghanistan reconciliation peace process. So this is the prospective analysis for mains examination, UPSC perspective. And there is another news which talks about a report which has been taken up by Fitch Solutions, and it has said that despite several healthcare reforms in India, India still remains badly placed to tackle the current wave of the COVID-19 pandemic situation, which the country is now experiencing the second wave. And the Fitch Solution has highlighted the need to increase investments in the healthcare. That is, in spite of several healthcare reforms taken up by the government of India during the COVID-19 pandemic situation in 2020, still in the year 2021, the Fitch solution is highlighting that there is need to increase investments in the healthcare system. So this is the keyword or the key phrase which you need to focus in regards to the healthcare investments or investment in the healthcare. And the virus is spreading very rapidly in India. And the Fitch solution has said that this spread of virus rapidly is due to the complacency of the Indians in regards to the maintaining social distancing measures and mask wearing policies. So these are the two reasons which the Fitch solutions have put forward to the spreading virus rapidly due to the complacency of social distancing measures and mask wearing policies. And across India, the daily COVID-19 cases have crossed the grim milestone of 2 lakh and several hospitals in the country are stretched beyond their capacities. And this is the point which the Fitch solution has said that there is a need to increase the investment in healthcare system, in India's healthcare system. That is a crucial one. Need to increase investment in India's healthcare system. And we would also focus at the inadequate cover which the healthcare system in India is right now possessing. So if you look at, for 10,000 population, we have 8.5 hospital beds. And for 10,000, we have 10,000 population, we have 8 physician. And this is the condition which it is, the healthcare sector is not totally equipped to handle such a crisis or the kind of virus which is spreading virulent in India. And if you look at 80% of the population do not have the health insurance coverage, and 68% have limited or no access to essential medicine. So these are all the inadequate cover which are responsible for the spread of virus. And in spite of taking, or despite the healthcare reforms taken up by the government of India in the year 2020, there is still a necessity that there should be, or there is a need for more of investment in the healthcare system. And the low level of public spending on health is both a cause and it is exaggerating the factor for poor quality, limited reach and insufficient public provisioning of healthcare. So what are the reasons that is for the poor quality, limited reach and insufficient public provisioning of healthcare? Is because of the low level of public spending on health. So what is important is the government of India has to pitch in very, very practically and rationally, that they have to make sure that the investment is required, increased investment is required in the India's healthcare system. And states such as Maharashtra, Delhi, Tamil Nadu, Punjab and Karnataka has the maximum load of the virus which is spreading virulent. And definitely there is falling short of healthcare infrastructure and equipment, ranging from oxygen to ventilators in these states. That is why there is a need for the increased investments in the healthcare or India's healthcare system. So this is a key phrase, how you need to focus in regards to the health and the kind of the study taken up by the Fitch solution. The highlighted point by the Fitch solution is that the India or the government of India's is need to increase the investment in healthcare system. And there is another report which we would be focusing is that now the Supreme Court is asking the CBI to look into the panel report, that is in regards to the DK Jain committee panel report which has been submitted to the Supreme Court. And in turn, now the Supreme Court has ordered the CBI to look into the Justice DK Jain committee report in regards to the Kerala police officials who have allegedly framed the space scientist Nambi Narayanan in the ISRO espionage case of 1994. So here the Supreme Court has appointed the committee. Supreme Court has appointed the committee, that is 3-member committee. And in turn, the 3-member committee, which was led by the DK Jain has submitted the report or the recommendation to the Supreme Court in the sealed cover, and in turn now when the sealed cover has reached the Supreme Court, now the Supreme Court has ordered the CBI to look into the report which has been submitted by the DK Jain committee in regards to the space scientist Nambi Narayanan, who was allegedly framed by the Kerala police officials in the ISRO espionage case of 1994. So here the keyword is ISRO espionage case of 1994 against the space scientist Nambi Narayanan. And the Supreme Court has barred any kind of public circulation of the contents or the report or the recommendation which was provided by the DK Jain committee to the Supreme Court. And the Supreme Court now copy would be placed in a sealed cover to the Central Bureau of Investigation, and thereby the CBI would look into the DK Jain committee report on the ISRO espionage case of 1994. And the committee was constituted by the Supreme Court in the year 2018 to find out whether the ways and means for the espionage case of 1994 against Nambi Narayan, that there would be an appropriate steps against the erring officials who have allegedly framed the case against the ISRO space scientist Nambi Narayanan. So here the point is, the committee was constituted in the year 2018 by the Supreme Court. This is important, by the Supreme Court. And the center has applied to the Supreme Court that they would urge the acceptance of the record of the inquiry made by the DK Jain committee, and the center is now has the Supreme Court to take suitable actions against the erring officials who have allegedly framed against the Nambi Narayanan space scientist. And now we will look at what were the alleged, the kind of the framing of alleged case, that is espionage case of 1994. It is based on passing on documents. So we will look at what or how the police, Kerala police, have investigated, and then they have framed case against the ISRO scientist Nambi Narayan. So he was arrested on November 30, 1994. Please do understand, the space scientists were arrested on November 30, 1994. But we will look at, the committee was constituted by the Supreme Court in the year 2018. 1994, he was arrested, and 2018, the Supreme Court has constituted a committee under the chairman of DK Jain to look into the ways and means to take appropriate steps against the erring officials who have allegedly framed case against Nambi Narayan in the year 1994. He was arrested in the year 1994. A committee was constituted by Supreme Court in the year 2018. And he was arrested while he was working on a cryogenic engine technology at ISRO. And the police, that is Kerala police, have investigated and they have accused Nambi Narayan in passing the documents and drawings. They have accused or they framed the charges against Nambi Narayan and arrested him because he has passed, that is the police, Kerala police, have mentioned that he has passed documents and drawings related to ISRO, which were in regards to the Viking or Vikas engine technology, in regards to the cryogenic engine technology, and in regards to the PSLV flight data drawings to Pakistan. And this was the allegations by the Kerala police, and they have arrested Nambi Narayan on November 30, 1994. And the Supreme Court had dismissed the case in 2018 as a criminal frame up. Look at it. 1994, they have arrested, and 2018, the Supreme Court has dismissed the case in the year 2018, considering the case as a criminal frame up based on some kind of fancy or notion. And in turn, from 1994 till 2018, the space scientist Nambi Narayan's career has got smothered. And that is why, again, he has approached the Supreme Court as and he wanted the action to be taken against the police, Kerala police, and few of the officials for his career getting smothered. And in turn, the Supreme Court in the year 2018 has constituted a committee and they wanted to come up with the ways and means to take action against the erring officials who have framed or who have supported the Kerala police to arrest Nambi Narayan. And this is now in regards to the Supreme Court ordering the CBI to look into the report submitted by DK Jain committee. So this is part of the polity. You can consider this. And I hope this session was informative, knowledgeable, and also very, very crucial, critical for UPSC mains as well as prelims perspective. So I would say very big thank you to all. Good luck to you all. Do maintain consistency, stick to your schedule, and take care of your physical health and mental health. And do not forget to like the video, share the video, and subscribe the AKS IAS Academy English Medium YouTube channel. And also have access to the website and Telegram link of AKS IAS Academy. And then see you again tomorrow with the AKS IAS Academy Daily News Analysis. Till then, thank you, goodbye, and then take care.